So, last week I told you everything about Maximum Carnage, and now it's time for its very illustrious sequel, Separation Anxiety. And this game is very interesting. The most interesting thing about this is that there's actually a PC version. And that's also how I got to know the game. Way back in 1997, I bought that game for the PC and it wouldn't run. Yeah, it just had problems. It was one of those early Windows games, and I still had a 486 at the time with Windows 95, so, well, it should have worked, but for some reason there was some issue with DirectX, and just a lot of controls were weird. I couldn't control the game, so I returned it and I got Realms of Chaos instead. At the time it seemed like a good idea. Well, in retrospect, maybe I should have kept that Separation Anxiety game for the PC, because it seems to be quite rare now. But I do have here a version for the Mega Drive and the Super Nintendo version. Well, actually, this is the Genesis version, because the Mega Drive PAL version is super rare. At least that's what they make you believe, because I saw it in a web shop in the Netherlands and it cost 300 euros there. Yes, 300 bloody euros, which is insane. I thought, well, bugger that. I'm just going to look on eBay myself, and I found this for only 70 euros, which is a lot cheaper. Well, I still had to shell out about 100 euros for this one, but yeah. It's a rare game, unfortunately, and still, it's not as good as Maximum Carnage, actually. They just removed all sorts of nice things from the game. At least, it's not as polished. It's still a decent game. It plays fine. It's still as difficult and as frustrating as hell, but luckily, we now have this sheet with passwords, because there's a password mode in it. So, and you can have unlimited lives and such, and have a level select screen. Oh, and by the way, the level select screen is actually quite interesting, because it has a build date. And it's different for the Super Nintendo and the Sega versions, but I'll get to that later. But yeah, the game is just like Maximum Carnage, except it's two players. And, well, it has different music, and the levels have been redesigned, and especially the art style. Maximum Carnage had that very nice, comic book cartoony art style, and this game does it completely differently. They spent about a year developing this game. In fact, they spent less than a year, because Maximum Carnage was released in October, November of 94, and this game was released, well, almost exactly a year later. And, well, yeah, what did they do in that year? Well, they just redesigned all the character sprites, because at the time Donkey Kong Country had been released, and its very nice pre-rendered graphics kinda caused a bit of a stir in the gaming world, because it was revolutionary to have all these pre-rendered graphics, and that's exactly what they did. They redesigned it with pre-rendered graphics, just like Rise of the Robots and Killer Instinct and Donkey Kong Country. Well, I don't think it really comes across all that well here on the camera, but yeah, the kind of cartoony style is gone, and it's been replaced a little bit with pre-rendered graphics. I think it's a bit of a hybrid. The result doesn't look as nice as Donkey Kong Country, but it just feels they use the same kind of process to create the graphics. And well, they just gave it a two-player mode, and that's about it, really. There's one thing I really feel about the game, and that it's probably a little bit unfinished or rushed in a way. It's not as polished as Maximum Carnage, and that's, well, really because those nice comic book cutscenes are completely absent. They have been replaced with just standard text on a black background with a picture of Spidey or Venom behind it, and that's about it. Yeah, that's all she wrote. No more nice comic book cutscenes. So I think they just had to rush the game, and maybe the sequel wasn't really planned. I don't really know why they bothered with it. Maybe they wanted to do two Venom Spider-Man games when they started. I don't know. maybe they had the license to do two games, or maybe they just thought, Maximum Carnage actually well received, let's do a sequel. I don't know. If any of the viewers are one of the former developers, then please enlighten me, because there's a lot of curiosity about this game, especially about the PC version. I mean, why wasn't it a DOS game? A lot of acclaimed games from the time were developed by Probe Software, and around 95-96 they still made their games for DOS using a DOS extender. But this game was for Windows, using the very first and really buggy version of DirectX. So why? I mean, that's rather interesting. I'd really like to know the story behind it. So, enough chit-chat, let's have a look at the game. Alright, now it's time for Separation Anxiety. And this is also on the Super Nintendo at first and later on the Mega Drive. And the first thing you see, this is published by Acclaim Entertainment, not LJN anymore, and still developed by Software Creations. The mysterious Life Foundation captured the lethal protector called Venom and removed 5 symbiote spawn from him. But before these new symbiotes could destroy their parent, Venom escaped. Now he is forced to seek out his old foe Spider-Man and forge an uneasy alliance, blah blah, can't read the rest. Web swinging high above the streets of Manhattan, Spider-Man saw the unlikely sight of his arch foe, Venom. And the Foundation planned to bond the symbiote with their soldiers, creating a small but yada yada yada, and the rest goes on. It's really not that interesting anymore. Sadly, they just removed all the nice comic book cutscene panels, and right off the bat, here you've got a secret room which only works for Spider-Man. Somehow Spider-Man has secret rooms in his game and Venom doesn't really. Or maybe Venom has some, I don't know, I haven't played the game that much, but yeah, you just beat up these few guys, and after you've done so, you get some extra lives. Depending how well you did, you may either get one or a few more extra lives. In this case, I only got one. So, the fighting is, just feels a little bit flimsier. It doesn't feel as solid as Maximum Carnage, even though it's still more or less the same game and you're still beating up those, 90s people with sports outfits. I mean, the girls still look pretty sporty, as well as the boys there with their baseball caps and their t-shirts. Yeah, they just really look like pretty generic mid-90s people, actually. And, here's Venom. And as you can see, Venom does not have a secret stage. And pretty quickly we reach the special screen here that you can enter by entering a password. And let's go to the underground city. And the underground city actually has quite a nice soundtrack, but in the Sega version they removed that particular song, which is a bit stupid, because it's a pretty nice bit of sound actually. It's one of the few pieces of soundtrack that was carried over from Maximum Carnage. The rest was completely redone and it just isn't as good. The graphics here, they look a little bit computer generated. It's really a hybrid between CGI and traditional pixel art. The result looks a little bit unconvincing. It's not bad, but the look is not as consistent as Maximum Carnage. Also, I think the fighting mechanics have gone downhill a little bit. In Maximum Carnage, they were really good. The controls were very tight and very solid, and it just felt really positive. And in Separation Anxiety, everything feels a little bit flimsy. It just doesn't feel as certain or as solid. For some reason, they just tweaked a bit of the engine, and it feels a bit backwards. It almost feels like this would be a prequel and Maximum Carnage the sequel. But unfortunately it's the other way around. This is just a weird case where the original game is just a lot better than the sequel. And well, still, it's more or less the same fighting mechanics. There isn't really that much difference here. It's, well, more of the same really. So, we're now in the mall. And Venom goes with the lift. Yeah. He's just like Beano, he rides lifts. And Spider-Man will ride the lift a little bit later too. And now we are in the underground... No, this is not an underground. This is actually a ventilation duct. And you have to punch up some orbs. Some kind of robot thingies. Don't know what they are. And here is a high-tech greenhouse. And yeah, the backgrounds, they look a bit weird. I just can't tell if this is pixel art or CGI. It feels like a mixed bag. It's a bit of a hodgepodge of both. And those robots there, they are bloody annoying, especially in the warehouse level, where they're pretty tough. What is Venom doing now? Let's see. He's just waiting. Oh hey, there's a purple looking symbiote. It must be one of his offspring. And that's the recurring theme in this game, that you have to fight some of the bosses who are just symbiotes. And now we go to the Sega version. And the Sega version is, well, the exact same thing really, except the graphics and the sound have taken a hit. Well, at least to some extent anyway. The colors are now 64 colors instead of 256 colors, and the music is now FM synthesis instead of sampled sound fonts. And yeah, the graphics, again, they've taken a hit. Whereas Maximum Carnage looked really good on both the Super Nintendo and the Mega Drive, in this case you're really better off with the Super Nintendo version. The boss was pretty easy, there was a digger, and now we are on a bridge, and on this bridge you have to web-sling. There are a few gaps actually that you have to cross, like here for instance, and it's really not that hard. You basically can't do anything wrong unless you're pretty stupid. I mean, you actually have to try hard to fall into the gap. The web-slinging is pretty easy. Just don't know what that boss is. You also have to fight that boss later. And here's Venom again. Now we're in the woods, and he's fighting, I think, some Life Foundation soldiers. Oh, and you have to fight that same stupid boss over again. And I just cornered him in the right corner, and then it's very easy to beat him. So I get a little help from Captain America. This is a feature that was carried over from Maximum Carnage. Very nice. And the boss you have to fight here is really just a carbon copy of Venom himself. They just painted him black, removed his tongue, and yeah, that's kind of cheap. And sometimes you get these passwords. But the game is quite sparse with passwords. But as you can see, the story is just now just boring text on black background with a picture of Venom or Spider-Man. It just doesn't look as attractive anymore as Maximum Carnage. And this is why I think the game was rushed. It just has an unfinished feel to it. It seems like they just had to quickly slap this together, and maybe they wanted it to become nicer than it actually became. But yeah, maybe the publisher said, oh, we're just gonna give you a year to do this project, and well, it seems like the story was a bit of an afterthought perhaps. And here's the underground city on the Mega Drive version, and notice the nice music is gone. And this is the warehouse stage, and yeah, I'm picking up that hard here, but really regretted that, because this stage is hard, and you really need to save those hearts. And here's the mall again, and Spidey's going with the lift. He's, well, he's not surfing the lift, but he's just sitting in the cab. So that's this is one of the later stages in the game. It's called Carnage's resting place, and this is probably at the heart of the Life Foundation. And here you have to fight all those damn bosses again. And there's another symbiote kit, one of Venom's spawns, and that was it. Game over. And that's about all she wrote about this game. So, as you can see, it's more or less, well, it's more of the same really, but not as good. Alright, let's briefly look at the DOS version. I managed to install Windows 95 in DOSBox, and that was very tedious and difficult. And I did it to just show you this game. So let's start our emulated Windows 95. And I have to say, the Windows version of Separation Anxiety is extremely buggy. So first let's have a look at the directory with the files, and I will show you the install program, and it sucks because it doesn't work. Yeah, fail to install, and then we have this thing, install. Well, that doesn't work, and you'll notice that the game will probably run too fast, and it also depends on the resolution, and it's very temperamental. So, anxiety.exe. Oh. You see, as you can hear, this is MIDI music. And this is the game in a proper speed. And the password screen also works. Let's see if I can zoom the screen a little bit. Should be able to resize it. Oh, can't make it any bigger. Oh, that's decent. Well, I'll just go look up those cheat codes. Oh yeah, the keys for this game are also really weird. And the password. Let's do... S C B C R S. One player game, and as you can see in the console versions, there is a build date in the menu, but in this version it's not the case. So let's choose Underground City. Let's choose Venom. So as you can see, this runs way too fast. So fast it's basically unplayable. And this game does not work with any modern DirectX version. It was made with the very first version of DirectX, and it just, well, it has all sorts of compatibility problems. And if I press F9, I should be able to bring in Spider-Man, but the controls are really weird. And now let's try changing resolution. Oh, you see, it runs slower now. And... all the sprites are now black. See if I can zoom this screen in for a bit. No, it doesn't work, unfortunately. But yeah, this is extremely temperamental, and it just doesn't work right. So I think Spider-Man is almost game over. But yeah, controlling the game is problematic. And the music you're hearing is general MIDI, so the way it sounds really depends on the kind of sound fonts or the sound card. Oh, let's try another level. Yeah, it just doesn't run all that great. So let's exit the game. So that was a look at the Windows version. And as you can see, it's, well, pretty damn temperamental. And this should also be the very first version. This says version 4.30, but DirectX 4 was never released. This is actually DirectX 1, believe it or not. And yeah, DirectX 1 had a lot of problems and bugs associated with it. And that's just a bummer. They really should have made this game for DOS instead. Then it would have been worthwhile tracking down a copy of the PC version. But yeah, the Windows version is pretty much obsolete. So that was a look at the Windows version. Okay, I've done a few experiments. I have now set the OPL mode to OPL2. And you'll notice that the sound is all garbled up, and also, well, the speed is now actually correct. When you set the DOSBox at 20,000 cycles, the speed of the game is now the speed it should have. So let's just test this. It all sounds really funny and completely, well, not right anymore, as you can notice. So that was a fun experiment, but by default the game seems to use OPL3. I don't know if it can use any sort of sound canvas thing with sound fonts. I haven't tried that out. I don't have any of that hardware, and I don't know how to do that in DOSBox, but I think this was a funny experiment. Okay, let's set the sound now to now the proper sound it should have, which is OPL3, but it's the auto mode. So you see, this is the correct way it should sound, but still I don't know how to make Spider-Man punch. Somehow the controls are a bit weird. The controls are so illogically laid out, actually. It's just a mess. But yeah, at 20,000 cycles it seems to run right. Alright, I discovered something very interesting about the PC version of Separation Anxiety. It uses a very early version of DirectX, but as you can see here, there aren't much files in terms of external files with resources in it. You have these XMI files, I don't know what those are, but I discovered something interesting when looking at it with a resource hacking program. It seems like the game has embedded resources. This is a technical feature of Windows executables, that you can embed icons and WAV files and other data resources in executable files. So let's have a look at it. We start a resource hacker, and then I'll open up this copy of the file, and you can see here is a structure. There's WAV, icon, RC data and icon group. And now if I expand this, you can see arrow, and it's a sound effect. Here are all the sound effects of the game. So those are the game's sound effects, and what can we else find? Well, here's an icon. This is the Spider-Man icon. And here is a well, a list of some data. The back list, and then the fore list, the MIDI list, surf list, icon group, and here's the icon again. But this is interesting, mid list. I wonder what this could be. I have no idea. Maybe it's MIDI data. I don't know. The game uses some kind of general MIDI style soundtrack in Windows, and I wonder if the game has embedded MIDI files. But yeah, these WAV files. It should be possible to extract them, because I can say save as. Actually, no, that doesn't seem to work. Maybe there's a different way. Let's see. This is just a... Oh, hey, that's interesting. Save WAV resource as. And I think you can even replace resources. This is what sound effect was this? Oh, arrow.wave. So we now have arrow.wave as a separate file. Let's see where it is. If I can find it again. Oh yes, here, arrow.wave. Oh yeah, this is all stupid with these media players, but here. I just extracted the sound effect from the game. Oops, yeah, that media player is very buggy and crashy. But now let's take a look at some of the other executables. What about the install program? The thing that doesn't really work right. Well, let's see. There's an icon again. But some programs also have dialog boxes in them. Let's see, what is this? Oh yes, here we have a dialog. It appears right here. This is just a dialog from the game installer, apparently. And here's some other data. So yeah, that's rather interesting, and let's see, let's look at some of these DLL files. DLL 16, oh, it doesn't work. So anyway, that was a short look at the, the hacking some resources and looking a little bit at the internals of the game. So that was a bit of gameplay of Separation Anxiety. Well, what are my final thoughts about this? I think if you want to play this game, you should get the console versions. You can't go wrong with either one of them, they're both fine. Audio-visually, the Super Nintendo version is a bit better, but just as with Maximum Carnage, the game plays smoother on the Mega Drive. The PC version is not really worth your while. Graphically, it's just like the SNES version, but the music is just that general MIDI thing, and it can sound anything from like Mega Drive style FM synthesis to like Roland Sound Canvas sound fonty stuff. So yeah, that's really because of the DirectX thing. And the PC version just is obsolete because, well, it uses a very ancient version of DirectX, and it's not compatible with any modern Windows version anymore. In fact, I think you can even have problems on Windows 98 with it, because Windows 98 already came with a DirectX version that is newer than the game uses. And those early DirectX versions, they were plagued with problems, and that's also probably the reason why a lot of developers were kind of hesitant to embrace DirectX for about 1.5 to 2 years. So yeah, I'd say if you want the game, just get the Sega version or the Super Nintendo version, whatever you floats your boat. I enjoyed it on both platforms, I'd say. Thanks for watching.